Hey guys, so I've had some questions about my favorite running shoes, what I like to wear when I run. If you follow me on Instagram, you probably see a lot of my posts on there as far as what shoes I'm wearing when I'm running. And mostly it's honestly Ultra, but I do have some other brands that I really like, such as Topo and Hoka. So I want to talk about my top five favorite running shoes, sort of my go-to shoes for running. And I have a lot of shoes, I'm just gonna be honest. And I do alternate, like I rotate between a different pair of shoes pretty much every day. It's rare for me to go 2 days in a row and wear the exact same shoe. So in this video, I'm gonna talk about my top five favorite running shoes, and then I'll do another video in like a week or two about my trail shoes, because if I were to talk about it all in one video, it would be a really, really long video because I love shoes. So I'm just gonna start with like my least favorite, I guess, and then kind of go up to my most favorite. So number five in my list is going to be the Hoka Rincon. I like these shoes a lot. Honestly, they've made my top five. I probably have close to 15 pairs of different running shoes. So these are ones that I reach for maybe once a week. And also I will tell you guys, I don't only run 7 times a week. So like my math may not add up here when I'm telling you how many times I reach for a pair of shoes in a week. I tend to run maybe like 10 to 12 times a week. Like there are many, many days where I do 2 days, you might call it, where I'll run in the morning and run at night as well, or you know, in the evening as well. So yeah, my math is not gonna add up to just 7 times in a week. It may be a lot more than that. So at least one run a week, usually a shorter run, I will go for my Rincons. And honestly, the only reason that they are not higher up on the list is because of the toe box shape. So if you guys know anything about running shoes or shoes in general at all, anything with a wide toe box or a foot shape is better for your feet. I have been wearing correct toes, which if you don't know what that is, feel free to look it up. But basically it aligns your toes in the shape or alignment that they would have been when you were born. Most of us are born with perfect feet, unless you have obviously some sort of orthopedic issues. But most of us, majority of us are born with perfect feet. If you look at a kid, look at a baby, their feet look like they should. But then over time we wear unnatural footwear, especially women. We tend to wear pointy shoes, high-heeled shoes. Honestly, all that does is it pushes our toes into a really abnormal alignment, and that lift in the heel puts a lot of pressure on the forefoot. So I tend to go for shoes that are wider in the midfoot and forefoot, and then also shoes that have a low drop. So the Rincon, I believe, has a 5 millimeter drop, or basically that's just a 5 millimeter heel raise, like from the toe to the heel, there's only 5 millimeters difference. So the reason these are not higher on my list is just simply because of the toe box. They are definitely wider in the midfoot. Like I can wear my correct toes with the Rincon for a little while, but after some time, it will start to push a little bit on my pinky toe. So I do wish that that Hoka's had the foot shape. They would definitely be much higher on my list, but they are wide enough in the midfoot that they're still comfortable. I have issues with bunions, especially in my left foot. My right foot is a little bit misaligned. My left foot really have some pain. I've gotten some immobility in that first toe joint. So that's why I started switching to shoes that had, you know, the wider forefoot and midfoot. And I've noticed a huge difference. So I try not to spend too much time in shoes with the tapered toe box. To be quite honest, the Brooks Adrenaline, these used to be my absolute most favorite shoe. These were the only shoes that I ran in. I loved them, I bought them for years, and I still love them. I still own a couple pairs. I will wear them, you know, for a few hours to work, or if I'm having a lot of trouble with my Achilles, I will grab my Brooks just for like a run. I still love Brooks shoes. The only thing I don't like is the toe shape, the foot shape. I can get them in a wide and it's a little bit better, but it still has the tapered toe box. So the thing with the Brooks, at least with the Adrenaline GTS, is it has a 12 millimeter raise from toe to heel. You can probably even just see that looking at it. And for me, that's a little bit much to be comfortable for all of my runs, or to be comfortable, you know, walking around it all day. I've gotten used to the low drop or the zero drop, so yeah, these are unfortunately not really on my list of top five anymore. I still love them, I still reach for them occasionally, but not every week and not consistently. So yeah, Hoka Rincon, number 5 on the list. I really love how lightweight these are. I don't know the exact dimensions as far as the weight, but they are super, super lightweight. Like I don't even feel like I have anything in my hand right now. They still got a lot of cushion. It is actually their one of their lighter weight shoes as far as cushion. This is more their speed shoe, but it still has a lot of cushion here. And so if I'm having, you know, really painful knee day or something, I'll reach for these for sure. Number four on my list is going to be the Ultra Provision. And honestly, there's really only a reason or two why they're not a little bit higher on my list. The Provisions are a stability shoe, which basically means they have some structure in the heel here and also a guide rail system in the arch to prevent the foot from overpronating too much. Some pronation is normal, but if you lean too much, you break in too much at that ankle, you really can get some problems. So the reason I used to be in the Brooks Adrenaline is because it is a stability shoe. It's got some pretty decent stability to it. But honestly, I've been working with my hip strengthening exercises. Overpronation mostly has to do with your strength and stability in your hips. It can do with a lot of other things as well, but I've been working on hip and glute strengthening and, you know, working with my correct toes, really being conscious of my foot strike and all that sort of thing over the last really solid year. So I don't necessarily need a stability shoe anymore, but I like to keep one or two on hand just for if, like, I'm going for a longer run. I know that past probably mile 15, 16, somewhere in there, I'm gonna start getting a little lazy with my strike. I may have some overpronation issues when I start to get a little more tired. Definitely a 20 mile plus run, I'm gonna be reaching for a stability shoe. And it's probably gonna be my Provisions because honestly, I love the amount of cushion they have. They're not super, super cushioned as you can see, but they're not quite as minimalistic as some other shoes. Obviously anything Ultra is going to have that foot shape. You can probably tell the difference there between the foot shape and the tapered toe box. This is a traditional running shoe, tennis shoe, whatever you want to call it. This is going to be that traditional shape. This is the shape that we should reach for most of the time. Honestly, all of the time, but I still like other shoes for different reasons. But anyway, so foot shape, got a little bit of stability here. This is one of their more mild stability shoes. I used to absolutely love the Ultra Paradigm. As you can see, these are well-loved, very worn, like no tread left on the bottom. I don't even know how many miles these have on them, 400 plus, probably close to 500. But these used to be like my go-to shoe as well as the Adrenaline. Also, they have the foot shape here, but the Paradigm really has a lot of cushion. This is the Paradigm 4.5, I believe. The 5 has even more cushion, and I really don't like the shape of it as much. So that's why I kind of transitioned to the Provision just to try it out. So you can obviously see the difference here. There's a lot more stability in the Paradigm and a lot more cushion. So it's definitely not my go-to shoe anymore just because it has too much going on for me. I'm trying to work on strengthening my feet and trying to get away from all that extra cushion, stability, that sort of thing. So the Provision is basically a lighter version of the Paradigm model. So I find that I like it for right now for what I need. I like the Provision a little bit better than the Paradigm. All right, and number three on my list is going to be the Topo Ultrafly. This is the new Ultrafly, the Ultrafly 3. I've had the 1 and the 2. I honestly don't know what happened to them. They're somewhere in my closet, or I may have like recycled them by now. I'm not really sure. I wore them out. I put so many miles on my old Ultraflies, and I've always really liked Topo, again, because of the foot shape. However, with the 1 and the 2, I always felt like they were just a little bit too narrow, and so I would usually reach for my Ultras over my Topos. But with the newest model of the Ultrafly, I am finding that I will sometimes reach for these over my Ultras. And the reason for that is because they really, really widened the midfoot in the Ultrafly 3. I absolutely love these shoes. Topo, well done. This is your best shoe yet, in my personal opinion. I love these shoes. And the only reason that they're honestly not a little bit higher on my list is they're really firm, which I like a firm shoe, as you're gonna see that with my number one pick. But I tend to, these have a little bit of light stability as well, so I tend to reach for these for my longer runs, my longer-ish runs. And sometimes after about, again, that 16, 17 mile mark, somewhere in there, I really just want a cushier shoe than what this provides. So this is like a good half marathon shoe for me, something in that training run distance where I might get a little fatigued. This has even lighter stability than the Provision, in my opinion. It doesn't have anything in the arch here. It just has a little bit of structure. You can kind of tell it cups the heel just a little bit. This isn't even, some people don't even classify this as a stability shoe because it's such light stability. So I don't usually reach for it like necessarily for stability purposes. But I just really like this as an overall go-to shoe, I guess. I will use it for speed work. I'll sometimes use it for hill work because it has a little bit of lift in the heel. This has a 5 millimeter drop as well. So I will reach for this just kind of as, it's one of my go-to shoes, to be honest. I would say that I use this at least 3 to 4 times a week. I didn't speak about the Provision, how many times I use it. just going to backtrack for a second. I'll probably reach for the Provision maybe once a week, maybe twice a week if I'm really having some fatigue issues with like my muscles. but the Ultra, all of Ultra shoes are completely zero drop. So if I'm having a little bit of Achilles issues, I'll definitely reach for my Topos or my Hokas, something like that, to give just a little bit of relief to the Achilles. So this is definitely one of my top three shoes for a reason. Honestly, this and my other top two that I'm about to get to are really, all really, really close. Like, I could easily pick any of these as number one. So, yep, there's the Ultrafly. You can tell they're well-loved, well-worn. Top three favorite shoes right here. I absolutely love these. All right, and my number two shoe by a very, very slim margin, these are so close to number one, it's unreal, is the Ultra Torin Plush. Now, I used to use the Ultra Torin. Sorry, I'm just gonna reach down here and grab these. These are the regular Torins. I think these might be the original ones. I can't remember. These are very, very old. These were honestly probably the first shoe I ever bought other than my Brooks Adrenaline. I think this was like when I started to break away from that just a little bit. I transitioned to the Ultra Torin, which is a huge, huge change from the 12 millimeter drop in the Brooks. So if you're gonna transition from a shoe with a heel lift to a zero drop, do it gradually, do it slowly. Don't do what I did and just like start putting it on every day and going for runs in it, because you're gonna get Achilles issues like I have now, like 2 years later. So anyway, the Ultra Torin, the original Torin, is okay. It's an okay shoe. But the Torin Plush is such an upgrade. Like, these were an okay shoe for me. It was something that like everyone else in my run group wore, so I was like, oh, I'll wear them. But I didn't really know why. I didn't really fall in love with them. And honestly, they're just, comparatively, they're really thin. Like, the structure here is just not, it's not really all that great. And I've heard a lot of other people say that too. Like, older Ultras are not really, like, they've got some issues, I guess, with the integrity of like the structure or materials or whatever. But the new Torin Plush, I'm telling you guys, this could be my number one shoe easily. There's really just like one small reason why they're not. But I freaking love these shoes. This is my ultimate, this is my shoe that I grab for, I'd say, at least 50% of my runs, maybe even more than half. I love this shoe so much. I can't speak enough about it as far as how good it is. It's really, really cushioned, which, like I said earlier, sometimes I don't like. So that's the only reason it's not number one, is because it sometimes has a little bit too much cushion for me. But honestly, I've been having some knee trouble lately. I don't know, it's just the cold weather, I guess. And so I've been reaching for these more and more just because that cushion feels so, so good. And these only have maybe about 100 miles on them. I haven't worn these a whole lot yet. So you're probably thinking like, oh, you've only put like 100 miles on a shoe and you're already saying you're in love with it. And honestly, I mean, I haven't had any issues with it. I mean, that could change, I suppose, over time. But I really, really like the sock-like structure of the upper here. It's kind of that knit mesh style. Like I said, the cushion is unmatched for me. This outdoes Hoka even as far as the cushion. I love this shoe so much. Obviously zero drop from heel to toe, obviously the foot shape because it's Ultra. This definitely was not my favorite color. That's like my only negative thing I ever have to say about Ultra women's shoes, is sometimes the colors are not really that cute, but it's just what was available in the store. So it's just what I grabbed just to try the shoe out. But yeah, I love this shoe so ridiculously much. I mean, again, only got 100 miles on it. You can look at it and tell it's not really been worn that much yet, but I really don't see me ever moving away from the Torin Plush. As long as they keep this design the same, I love this shoe. I absolutely love it. So my number one shoe, and the only reason that the Torin Plush is not number one, is the Ultra Escalante Racer. Now, as far as the actual Escalante, just the regular Escalante, I really don't like it at all. It's not cushioned enough to be, you know, as useful as the Torin, but it's too cushioned to be as useful as the Racer. So me personally, I don't like the Escalante. I just don't like it. It doesn't feel good on my feet. But the first time I put on the Escalante Racer, and this is the reason why these shoes are number one, I said out loud, now that's how a shoe is supposed to feel. That was my quote. Now, I said that pretty much with the Torin too. I put them on and I was like, because before I had tried the Torin Plush, I had heard everybody rave about it for, you know, weeks and months or whatever. And I was like, I just don't get it. It just looks so clunky, whatever. But I tried it on and I was like, oh, I get it. I get why everyone loves it. That's what I said when I put that on. Oh, I get it. But this one, when I put it on, it was like, that is how a shoe is supposed to feel. You guys, these shoes, I could live in these. I mean, I will wear these all day to work. I will wear these for, I mean, I haven't taken them on more than probably a 10-mile run just because they are not very cushioned at all. And me personally, I get nervous about that. I can strengthen my feet and my bones and my muscles and all that and get up to that point where I could take these for a marathon plus if I wanted. But right now, I'm just not there yet. But these are absolutely incredible shoes. So obviously, you can tell the cushion here is not nearly as much as anything else I have showed you. These are quite firm, to be quite honest. I mean, they are designed to be a racer, so they're designed to be a speed shoe for sure. And I'm not a fast runner, so it's kind of weird that I would be the type of person that would reach for a racer. But I cannot get enough of these shoes. They have this really, really meshy upper, if you can kind of see here, like pretty much see-through. And I just grabbed the 4th of July version when I picked these up in the store because they were from last year, so they were a little bit discounted. So that's honestly the only reason I have them. Yes, they are designed to be this way. I don't have two different pairs of shoes. They are designed to be red, white, and blue. That's how Ultra released them last year when they released these. So yeah, again, obviously the foot shape, zero drop because they're Ultra, but just, I don't even know if I can exactly pinpoint 100% why I love them so much. Because again, they're a little firmer than what I would reach for. They're not very cushioned at all, but it feels so natural. And I mean, I think that's honestly, that's the point of going for any shoe, right? Is that it feels good on your feet. And that's obviously kind of what Ultra and even Topo and some of these other brands are going for, is this natural foot shape, you know, with the wider toe box and the zero drop, to be completely natural, not putting your foot into a compromised position. However, some of us with issues have to have extra things on our shoes. So this is not a shoe that I'd recommend for everyone. I mean, I'm not gonna obviously say that everyone should give this shoe a try. If you have issues with overpronation, or you have really bad issues with your Achilles, or you know, all kinds of other problems, for lack of a better word, that you need extra features on a shoe. But if you're looking for something very minimalistic, you're trying to make your running form as natural as possible when you're working on strengthening your body, and you want something that's just going to allow your feet to do what they're supposed to naturally do, this is the shoe. I love it. Absolutely love it. And the only reason I don't reach for it every day is because it's not super, super cushioned. So these are more for my shorter runs, my tempo runs, my speed work, that kind of thing. My Torrens and my Topos, I will reach for those, you know, more for everyday use just because they're a little more practical with that added cushion and support. But y'all, this is it. This is it. This and the Torren Plush are my top two favorite shoes. I feel so good in them. I just feel like this is exactly what my feet are supposed to be doing. So yeah, I hope this was helpful in some way. Obviously, I'm an Ultra fanatic. That's most of my favorite shoes are going to be Ultra, but I do have quite a bit of experience with most other brands. So if you have any specific questions, you can always ask them in the comments, and I'll do my best to answer from my experience and my semi-professional advice, if you want to call me that. Because I have sort of ventured into the health and fitness world. I do have some experience with coaching and footwear and health as far as running and that sort of thing. So if you want to tap into a little bit more of my professional advice, feel free. But again, this is only from my experience and from the professional advice that I have been given. Honestly, the best way to see if a shoe is going to be right for you is to go and try it on. Go to your local running specialty store and try on a shoe. Try on many shoes, see what works for you, be fitted professionally. This is just what's worked for me after years of experience and trial and error. I find that these are the shoes that I keep on hand all the time. Like I said, I do have many other shoes in my closet, but it's not shoes that I tend to reach for very often. These are the top five shoes that I go for. Every day I have on one of these pairs of shoes, pretty much. So yeah, I hope that this was helpful or entertaining, at least if, you know, you didn't find it helpful at all. Maybe you were amused by my shoe collection. Like I said, this is like not even half of it, but it's fine. I don't have a problem. It's fine. Anyway, I hope you guys are having a fantastic December so far. And that's all I have for today. So I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.